on the dice. My dear audience and my fellow contestants, today I, Mohammad Kar, would like to thank Hunar Creation Craft Association who have given me this wonderful opportunity to present my views on again the topic Tourism Not at the Cost of Culture. One of the major motivating factors of tourism is to meet new people and learn about their culture. And often it is lead to greater understanding between the people living in different societies. Improved tourism is also lead to local communities to undertake education and improve their skills to feel the part of development. In some cases, tourism may help to preserve traditional customs such as music, dance and theatre, as well as creating a demand for locally produced foods and drinks. Culture is increasingly an important element of tourism. It gave us wide range of employment and economic boost too. When travellers choose these type of tours and activities, they want authentic and culturally rich look, and these look goes from generation to generation. Culture and tourism not only gave us wide range of employment or economic boost, it is one of the largest and fastest growing industries. In some cases, we can say local people are undertake education and the tourists reserve and they help local communities. Let me give you an example. They buy a hand-woven scarf rather than mass-produced souvenir in shop. They dine in small family restaurants rather than internationally owned chain. They stay in a small guest house operated by locals rather than branded or five-star hotels. It means more money directly goes to the local person of that area. In recent years, concepts such as eco-tourism, sustainable tourism and responsible tourism have emerged. As a result, we can say it can be managed more carefully. Thank you, Jai Hind.
That was wonderful.